Dear students, today we will study the remaining part, that is the modes of speciation. You know that we have started the, as per syllabus, second unit and fourth chapter. In the second unit, fourth chapter, we have already studied, and from that fourth chapter, the name of chapter is species concept. And from the species concept, this is the last point is remain, the modes of the speciation. So here, dear students, this is the syllabus, and as per the syllabus, we are doing our work. We have to do our work as per the syllabus. Syllabus wise, आपल्याला आपलं कार्य करायचं आहे, point to point, एक एक complete करत आपल्याला पुढे चालायचं आहे. तर तीन चॅप्टर आपले झालेले आहेत आणि चौथा चॅप्टर मधला हा शेवटचा बीट आज आपण पूर्ण करणार आहोत. दॅट इज द मोड्स ऑफ स्पेशिएशन. मोड्स ऑफ स्पेशिएशन, हियर दिस इज द पॉइंट टू स्टडी टुडे. सो फर्स्ट वी शुड नो व्हाट इज द मोड्स ऑफ स्पेशिएशन. सो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ न्यू स्पेसिस, that means the modes of the speciation. Species, speciation, it is the plural, many species formation, that is the speciation. So modes of speciation is defined as the formation of new species in the environment. How new species form, that is today's our study. So here the Mayer, M-A-Y-E-R, Mayer is the name of scientist, and in 1959, so he gives the definition of the speciation, that is, species is a biological unit. Mayer states that species is a biological unit, or it is the smallest unit in the classification of animals. So Mayer states that species is a biological unit. Remember this. Here some points are selected for discussion, which is helpful to understand the modes of species. So Mayer in 1959 states that species is a biological unit. Biological, you know, biology. So species or modes of speciation helps to understand the evolution. Why? का गरज आहे, कशाला अभ्यासाचं, मोड्स ऑफ स्पेसिएशन आपण कशासाठी अभ्यासायचं. सो इट वी हॅव टू स्टडी फॉर टू अंडरस्टँड द इव्होल्युशन. वी आर स्टडींग द इव्होल्युशन. सो मोड्स ऑफ स्पेसिएशन हेल्प्स अस टू अंडरस्टँड द इव्होल्युशन. Species is a keystone of evolution. Remember, keystone of evolution. Speciation is the keystone of evolution. That's why we have to study the modes of speciation or concept of speciation. You are understanding? Listen carefully. You will understand easily, because it is not very hard, it is very easy. By reading also you can understand. Pustaka vachun, vahya vachun, notebook vachun sudha tumhala samje, evadha he sopa hai, it is easy to understand. So here we have to study the statement or views or opinion of the different scientists. Now evolution advances by the speciation. Evolution is advances by the speciation. For the study of evolution, we have to study the speciation. Then we will understand the evolution. It is the keystone of evolution. It helps to understand the evolution. Now, species or speciation is essential for diversification. Diversification of organic world, adaptive radiation and evolutionary process. So speciation is essential. Speciation is very important. It is very necessary. It is very essential. Kashyasaathi essential hai? For diversification. Kashyasaathi diversification of organic world. Organic means the organisms world. Then adaptive radiation and evolutionary process. Now the Lamarck, who have given the first theory about the organic evolution, that is called as the Lamarckism, by putting the different principles. So Lamarck states that new species develop by inheritance of acquired characters. Lamarck se kaay banna hai ki navin species ki develop hote, kisi develop hote, by the inheritance of acquired characters. Inheritance of acquired characters. Different scientists, different evolutionists have given the different statements to prove how the organisms are evolved. What is the keystone or milestone in the evolution? What is the proof of the evolution? What is the support of the evolution? So here Lamarck given the new species are developed. Navin species kaise develop hota? By the inheritance of acquired characters. As per the environment, new characters are developed as per the need, and that character which is developed requires many years. It is not sudden. And that characters are inherited from one generation to the next generation. So that is acquired characters. So here, development of inheritance of acquired characters. Now, what about the Darwin? Darwin's opinion is about the speciation. Darwin states that new species develop by the natural selection. Here, natural selection. Nisarga ha select karto asto. Unala jivant thevayche ani kunala finish karayche. That decided by the nature. That is called as the natural selection. Even though in the similar environment, even though they are obtaining the similar food, but there is the death of some of the offsprings. Why? They are failed to adapt. They are failed to adaptation. They are failed to adjust with the environment. That's why they are finished. And those animals, they adjust to their environment. Means those animals who are having the adaptive characters, adaptations. So nature select that. That is called as the natural selection. So here Darwin's opinion or Darwin states that new species develop by the natural selection. Now De Vries. De Vries also an evolutionist. So he says that sudden. De Vries states that sudden speciation by chromosomal aberration and mutation. Speciation is a sudden process according to the De Vries, and it is by the chromosomal aberration or by the mutation, which is the misprint, sudden change, and new species are originated. New species are developed. Sudden change due to the mutation. Now, there are two types of the speciation. Remember, in the modes of speciation, there are two types of the speciation. One type is called as the allopatric speciation, and second type is called as the sympatric speciation. So here, two figures are there for to clear understand. But due to this small sized board, I am unable to sketch the figure. Where should I sketch the figure? Work from home or online teaching is just like the adjustment, just like the adaptation. Adjust. So dear students, when our college is offline, period is offline, that time I will again revise this study. So here the two types of the speciation, that is the allopatric speciation and sympatric speciation. So dear students, listen here carefully. What is the allopatric speciation? So group of similar organisms in a population, big population, group of similar organisms that could interbreed. The group of similar organisms that could interbreed, they can do the reproduction, but they do not. But they do not. They karat nahi. Because kya karan hai? Because they are geographically separated. There is the barrier. That barrier separates these two species. That's why they cannot interbreed. They can do here group of similar organisms that could interbreed. They interbreed karu shakta, but they do not. But they do not because they are having the geographically separation or geographically barriers. That's why they cannot do the interbreed. Another type is the sympatric speciation. Here, in this type of speciation, group of similar organisms in a population, similar type of the organisms capable of interbreeding but do not interbreed because of different behavior. Ithe suddha the animal interbreed karat nahi, ka karat nahi, so due to the difference in the behavior. Ithe due to the geographical barrier. So try to understand this. Read these notes. I will send the notes in the PDF file on WhatsApp group. So dear students, today's period is on modes of speciation, which is remaining from the chapter number 4. So here today, the chapter number 4 is completed, and in next period, in fresh mood, we will start the next chapter, 5th chapter, from unit number 6. And here, you remember, after the completion of two units, दोन युनिट पूर्ण झाल्यानंतर आपण त्या दोन युनिटवरती